We've already explained how people breathe in space and on Mars, but there's still the issue of having enough food to eat. Food is obviously important to our survival, so we'd need plenty of it to make it out there on Mars. But can we grow enough food for a human colony to live on Mars? Can we grow food there at all? On space stations, astronauts have grown small crops like lettuce. In fancy growth systems that account for the low gravity and rotational orbit, these plants were analyzed and found to be totally fine for human consumption. But in those cramped little stations, we can't grow enough food to survive. So astronauts eat freeze-dried foods with liquid mixtures of seasonings like salt and pepper. For plants to survive, they need sufficient light energy, temperature, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water, and many other nutrients from the soil. And that's not really feasible on a space station. On Mars, however, having enough oxygen and carbon dioxide shouldn't be an issue, since we'd have the oxygen that the astronauts would be using anyway. And the atmosphere on Mars is made up of 95% carbon dioxide. But light energy would be the first key problem we've got to tackle here. Light intensity and wavelength are key to plant growth, as species need particular levels and wavelengths of light to grow. Unlike Earth, Mars doesn't have much of an atmosphere at all, so levels of ultraviolet light would be massive, and that's really bad for plants. And while Earth receives 1,300 watts of solar irradiance per square meter, Mars is almost 80 million kilometers further away from the Sun than Earth, so it only receives about 1,000 watts per square meter. A lower amount of light on Mars would mean that the plants may grow slower and to a reduced extent. So the best way to tackle both of these issues would be to use artificial lighting from energy produced from solar panels. Temperature is also a big problem for growing plants on Mars. The average temperature on Mars is about negative 55 degrees Celsius, or negative 67 degrees Fahrenheit, so it really wouldn't be suitable for plants at all. Water would freeze and plants would wither, and even the most cold-resistant organisms from Earth would just die. The best fix for this at the moment would be to grow plants in greenhouses that regulate the temperature, just like the other buildings on Mars would for the humans. Water would be another big issue here. Most of the water on Mars lies in the north and south poles of the planet, trapped in ice caps. In the summer, some of the ice melts, so we might be able to use the water from that to grow food and survive. Other than that, we'd have to rely on reusing water that we've brought along, and getting shipments of water back home from Earth. Plants also need a variety of macro and micronutrients in the soil to survive, including things like magnesium, sulfur, calcium, and phosphorus. Fortunately, scientists have detected all of these nutrients in the samples of Martian soil and in Martian meteorites. However, there might not be enough of these nutrients in the soil, depending on where the humans decide to land and grow food on Mars. So we'd have to choose a place with the optimal amount of each nutrient for plant growth, or just use some fertilizer. So, would you eat food that was grown in space or on Mars? Did you know that 9 billion Keurig-compatible coffee pods are thrown away and pollute the Earth every year? Glory Brew is stopping the waste by producing compostable coffee pods. Tag a friend and share this video so you can help save the planet, one cup of coffee at a time. Would you be willing to travel to Mars now that you know some of the problems that might come up? Let us know in the comments below, and subscribe if you want to be notified about our next video. Thanks for watching!